Praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We certainly thank God. Probably you. We certainly thank God for everything that He has done and everything He continues to do in our lives. Amen. So we give Him praise even on this day that it is, they said the heat, whatever it is 105 here in Fayetteville, and so it is hot. So we thank God, though, because it could be the other way. We could not be feeling anything. So we thank God for allowing us to be able to feel and have an example of this heat before us that says that we definitely don't want to spend eternity in hell, because I haven't been there. I'm not interested in going there, but they tell me it's going to be very, very hot. Amen. So to God be the glory. He's so kind to us that He gives us an example of what it could be in times like this. So to God be all the glory. Again, we thank Him for loving on us the way that He does. Amen. Amen. So I have an interesting message for you today. You might kind of feel like it's a kindergarten one, but it's going to bless your soul. I was a part of a workshop of sorts on yesterday, and at the end of it, we were asked by the presenter, Pastor Omar Dykes, how to with four objects. There were a pair of scissors, stapler, a mask, face mask, and the hand sanitizer. And he asked the question of how could we make a message out of one of those different things. So I chose the pair of scissors, and that's what we're going to talk about today. What does a simple pair of scissors mean to you in your life? What type of benefit could it be? What kind of example could it be for you in your life? And so we're going to talk about that in just a few minutes. Father God, in the name of your precious Son, Jesus, Lord God, we bless you and we thank you, for truly you are God and there's none like you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you woke us up this morning, Lord God. You did not have to do it. but you did, and we are forever grateful for it, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we bless your holy and righteous name and ask, Lord God, as we continue to go out throughout this day, that we are reminded over and over and over again just how good you are to us, Lord God. Even in the things that don't feel good, we know that you're working them for our good, Lord God. So we give you the glory, Lord God. We give you the honor. We ask, Lord God, that as you prepare to take us through this message here on this afternoon, Lord God, that your word would touch, Lord God, the hearts of your people, Lord God, that it will go to and fro with and throughout this community, Father, in the name of Jesus. I know we on one street, Lord God, but you are so omniscient, Lord God, we know that it can spread throughout the entire Fayetteville, North Carolina, Lord God, the entire state of North Carolina. So, Lord God, in the name of your son, Jesus, we're asking, Lord God, that you allow this word to touch your people, wherever they may be, Lord God. Allow it to do for them what it needs to do for them. And for those, Lord God, that may have another need, let it do what they need, Lord God. And let it start with me, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We bless you, Lord God. Oh, God, we look, Lord God, that you would be glorified by everything that we do. Father, that we would be edified, and again, the very devil that seeks to steal, kill, and destroy would be horrified. As a matter of fact, God, in the name of Jesus, we would believe right now, God, that he already is wobbling in his boots. Why? Because you gave us the breath of life on today. So we thank you, Father, that he is nervous because of who we are in you. So, Father, continue to strengthen us, Lord God, because we know he's not going to ever stop bothering us, Lord God. So give us your strength so we will be able to have even your word to fight against the wiles of the devil, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We honor you. We adore you. And we give you all of the glory in Jesus' precious and righteous name. Amen. Amen. All right, family. So here we go. So I've been having some technical difficulties with my tablet. It has decided that it doesn't want to work anymore. And so I will be using my paper to just keep me on task here because I want to make sure I stay focused. You know, and when I talk as much as I can talk, sometimes I might get a little off track. I don't want to get too far down the road that you can't reel me back in. So to God be the glory, I have the old-time way of doing things, a piece of paper. Amen. So we're going to work this and see what God does so that we will be able to get everything that he desires for us to get today. As I started out saying that this is going to be an interesting kind of message on today, because what I am going to do, we're going to talk about a pair of scissors. Amen. We're going to talk about pruning and patience. Amen. Everybody knows what pruning means, more so than a lot of folks, especially if you're in the Word of God, because we know that there's a pruning that we must go through in order to understand and deal with a lot of things that we have to deal with in this world. We know that because we were created by the hand of God, we were also born in sin and wrapped in iniquity, right? And so we have to go through a pruning process. In that pruning process, it doesn't always feel good, but we still have to do it because as we've been called by the hand of God to do great things for him, for kingdom building, there are some things that we must go through in order to be able to successfully take back everything that belongs to us, to successfully know how to speak to those that don't know Jesus and give them a word that's going to allow them to not be frustrated at us, but to know that God loves them and that we are able to speak with them in a way of gentleness and compassion versus in a way of condemnation. Amen. We need to be pruned, and that's what we're going to talk about. So my first scripture text is going to come from John chapter 15, verse 2. Amen. John chapter 15, verse 2. And it reads, every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that bear fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now, purge, when we think about purge, again, it's all about taking something through a process. Amen. We know that we are pruned all the day long through the different issues that we may go through in life. And We get so frustrated. Who wants to go through things that we feel are unnecessary? But they are necessary because, first of all, God is not sitting in heaven just twiddling his thumbs, wanting to make us uncomfortable. Everything he's doing is for a purpose, and it is in those places of where we feel a little bit uncomfortable that I tell you today that we are being pruned, amen? And don't get it twisted that just because we're up in age, we're not supposed to go through things. You know, some people think that it's like graduating high school. Well, I know everything I need to do. No, no, no. As long as you are alive, there is something for you to learn, amen? We never get to a place where we don't... Well, we have it all, and if we do, my mama would say, as long as you're green, you grow. But when you're ripe, you're rot. So then at that point, God may as well call you on home. Amen. I'm not ready to go yet. So keep me as, I'm not going to say simple-minded or dumb, but continue, Lord God, to give me more and more every day because I want to go as far as I can go in this thing. Now, when it is the right time, at the right old age, then yes, God, bring me on home. But for right now, I do know. See, I was supposed to put that in my hand. That's the problem. See, obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. So we're going to go through some things. And that's all right. Because we're going through it, that means that God's hand has allowed it to happen. And so it is not to kill us, to harm us, or cause us any type of trouble. It is to stretch us. It is to strengthen us. It is to make us be beautiful. Amen. In God's word. Amen. And what we have to do for his good pleasure. Amen. So for all those gardeners out there and folks that work in the florist and you deal with all of the flowers and things like that, and in the springtime we look forward to having the pretty flowers come up. Well, those things don't just happen by osmosis. They happen because something takes place during that time frame that is underground. Amen. And then even before the spring ends, what do? We start to prune them. We start to cut away different parts of the plant or what have you, so that when it comes back in the spring the following year, it's going to be good. Amen. And so that is what God is doing with us. He prunes us. Amen. So here we go. Here we are, putting scissors to the test. What can a pair of scissors do for your life? What can a pair of scissors do for my life? That pair of scissors can cut away. When you think about a pair of scissors and just take your mind back to doing decorations with your children or working in a school or any type of decorations there may be, amen, we use the scissors to cut away that which we don't want, amen? That's what we do. We use the scissors. The scissors cut away the parts of what we have put on a piece of paper because we don't want the ragged or jagged ends of it. We want the pretty picture that's going to come from it after we've cut all around the part that we've drawn out. And so what do we get after we have cut away all of what we don't want? This beautiful picture. So picture yourself, amen, pun intended, that you are this beautiful rose. You are this beautiful workmanship that God has called. God allows us to go through things so he can continue to trim away the pieces that don't belong, that he can continue to purge and prune that which does not belong, because otherwise we'll be walking around forever and a day like Linus. If you remember Linus in Charlie Brown, he's the one that he carried his little dirty towel. Yes, thank you, Mother Ela. He carried that thing. And so it just followed him around. No matter where he went, there it was. But somebody should have been able to help him so that he could someday get rid of that. Amen. And because if not, you got it? Amen. Hold on. Amen. So that he could get rid of that cloud, because when we don't get rid of the parts that don't belong, it follows us around. We're not able to do that which we need to do. As a matter of fact, it will weigh us down. Amen. Well, we can't do the things that God has intended us to do. It's like looking in the rearview mirror trying to go forward. It's impossible to get where you're trying to go to if you always looking forward, looking backwards, trying to go forward. You got to cut some things away. You got to let some things go. And that's what happens in the story of the pair of scissors today. Amen. We are using those scissors as an object to show us what happens in the life of when we come to Jesus Christ. Some might say that we're being beat up. You know, why is God always doing this? Why is God always doing that? God is doing it because he knows that the end result of what is happening, you and I will be stretched and beautiful and able to do everything he created us to do. I shared with the morning service that we come away fearfully and wonderfully made. That's what the Bible says. So, of course, we have to have the pieces that don't belong. They have to come away. We also know that when it comes down to what they say, the basket of fruit. You got all the apples in there. And they say one bad apple can what? It can spoil the whole bunch. So you got to get rid of that which doesn't belong. So in the story of the scissors help us to know that, you know what? There's something that doesn't belong in this picture. There's something that does not belong, because what's going to happen, it's going to either spoil that which is good, or you'll never be able to move forward, period. Amen. So we have to learn to let that which does not belong, let it go. And sometimes those that comes in the idea of things that we might love, we might not want to let go. But we have to learn, family, that some things just can't go where we're going. I don't care how much we love it. I mean, God allowed, he let go his son to come and go to that cross for us so that we would have the right to the tree of life. Why is it that we can't let go something that's trying to keep us from having that tree of life? Amen. I don't understand. Amen. You know, I mean, that just doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. And I'm not portraying to be the smartest bub or smartest one in the group. But if something is preventing you from being all that God has created you and I to be, we got to let it go. Amen. Because that is just not going to work, and we're not going to be able to be as productive as we need to be when it comes down to the call on our lives. And so here we go. The story of Joseph. Remember Joseph? Joseph was, just an awesome young man. But Joseph had a dream early on. And because he had not yet been pruned, Joseph went out bragging about this dream that meant that what? His brothers were going to be bowing down to him. But his brothers didn't want nobody seeing him and seeing them as bowing down to them. I mean, that was a horrible fixed picture in their mind. So what did they do? We know the story is that they end up putting the boy in a pit. Amen? And so then they sold him away. I believe it goes to the folks to be a slave. But because God still had a plan for Joseph's life, he did not let Joseph die. Am I right? He still continued to watch over Joseph, because even though Joseph opened up his mouth too soon, amen, he did not allow the people to see what he was doing, God still loved him. The gift that God had given him in his life was not forsaken because he did not move or do things as he was supposed to. Amen. And might need water, cold water. But in any event, we thank God that's the same thing that God does with us. He does not forsake us, because the gifts of the Lord are without repentance. Amen. Even if we mess up, God is still God. God is still going to do exactly what he said he would do in our lives. Amen. So we have to trust God and allow God to move about in our lives, to do the things, take away the things that don't belong. Because trying to hold on to something that's not good for us, it will eventually kill us. It will stifle us from being able to do what God has called us to do. So here we find Joseph in this pit. Then he ends up going, from that story, he ends up going even once he gets into the palace, because now the enemy is just mad because, wait a minute, how did he manage to get out of that pit, that dry well? You know, what was it that he was was able to get out of that. Because when God has his hands on you, no devil in hell can take you away. So it did not stop what God was going to do with Joseph. Joseph just needed to be pruned. Am I right? Joseph just needed to have something, a little bit more maturity under his belt so that he could move in the way that God had wanted him to move. And so God continued to let his grace be sufficient in the life of Joseph so Joseph could be there for his family when the famine came. But before we get to there, Joseph had to even go through some more stuff. What is God doing? Why does Joseph have to be, keep going on through these different things that he's having to deal with? Because God loves him. And those whom God loves, he chastens. Am I right? Those whom God loves, no matter what happens, no matter what's taking place, God's hand, his righteous right hand, is still upon our lives. Because he has made a promise to our forefathers, those that have prayed for us, that our dear children would be saved. I know if it had not been for the prayers of the righteous for me, I wouldn't be standing here on this porch. I won't tell you what I would be doing, but anyway, I know I wouldn't be here because I know what I was before the Lord got a hold of me. Right. Amen? Right. And so I thank God that even in my place of not being ready, of moving too fast or not moving soon enough or allow myself to get hooked up, tied up, tangled up with the wrong people, that God did not let me go because of my immaturity or because I wasn't ready. Instead, he allowed me to go through even more stuff to begin to prune me, to turn me around, to make me want to be right there in the front of the line. Amen? To be right there. Whatever church I go to, you better bet I'm going to find myself to the altar. I'm going to be right there. I had one church to tell me, every time you come here, you act like I'm a member. I'm sorry. This ain't yours. This is my daddy's house. If I can't come here and get to the front, hey, where am I supposed to be? Right. This is my daddy's house. And I'm going to run and shout everywhere I go. You don't know me before I leave here. Amen. Because that's how God created me. If he didn't want me to do it, he'd have got somebody down the street. But here I am. Because I'm unashamed. Did I go through stuff like Joseph? Did I go through stuff like David? Did I go through stuff like Paul? You better bet I did. All right. But God is so faithful to us that even in our mess, he's using the pair of scissors to clip, clip, cut, cut, clip, go around this edge, take this piece off. I'm pruning them towards this direction. Oh, when they come out, they're going to be so beautiful. Hallelujah. He's turning the ashes into beauty. Amen. He's turning that which nobody else might want to be such a blessing, not just to our lives, but to those that would see us. The greatest message we will ever preach will be the one that we walk every day. What are people seeing when they see us walk? What are people seeing when they see us go through stuff? They are seeing or should be able to see, as they taught us in when I was 16, because I was such a tomboy, my mother sent me to the school called Barbizon. And I'd get off the bus when I got back home, and I'd still jump every cinder block wall there was. But in Barbizon, they would teach you even how to fall gracefully. How do you fall gracefully? Well, I didn't quite understand it when I was young. But when I got older, I understood if I did not learn how to fall gracefully, I was going to be breaking up a whole lot of bones in my body. So I learned how to do some things and make sure I fall this way versus that way. Because my two front teeth were so big, whatever was going to happen, it was going to grab those two front teeth. And I could not let that happen. So I learned real quick, yep, this is a good time for me to bring back that which I learned before. And that is what God wants us to do. He wants to look back. See what he's done for us in the past and bring it up to where we are right now. So when the devil is trying to take us out, all we got to do is reflect back to what he did before. He's the same God today, yesterday, and forevermore. Right, and he's got a plan for our lives. In that plan for our lives, he said that it is his goal that we would not just live life, but we would live an abundant life. We can't live that life broke down, busted, and disgusted. We got to be up on our game. So that means some things have got to go. Some things have got to go. As T-Mobile says, you just got to begin to scroll, select, and delete some things. Amen? Because everything can't go where you're going. Hallelujah. That's the God we serve. And he's good with us. He's trying to get us to get to that place where we're not ashamed to let people know that I'm sorry. Just because I'm a Christian don't mean I'm a flunky. Just because I'm a Christian don't mean I'm a punk. We can say no. No is not a bad word. Amen. Amen. Sometimes you just can't do stuff. Amen. Amen. But we won't know that unless we go through the pruning process of Jesus Christ, understanding that it is our spirit, the spirit of God that rests and rules in our bodies, that we will be able to know when and when not. Amen. And if you stay away from understanding the word of God, you're not going to know. And you and I will feel like every time we go through something, it's got to be the devil. Stop giving the devil all of God's credit. I'm telling you, we give all of God's credit to the devil over and over again because why? We have not read the word of God. God has to allow these things before anything can happen. And just like when we read the story of Joseph, what Joseph ended up saying in the end, he said what the enemy meant for evil, God turned it to his good. The story of a pair of scissors, amen? He had to go through a pruning process. He had to be laid out in the jail. He had to even learn the process of, wait a minute, everybody that says that they're going to help me when I get out, I might not see them jokers again. Right. They gonna forget about me when they get out, right? And so we gotta begin a relationship with God for ourselves so we're not relying upon people that mean us no good. Right. My Lord, oh my. I mean, we can have so many friends. So many friends. Everybody wants to be our friend. But how many really understand the definition of a friend? I feel like a friend is the one that's going to tell me that that slip ain't covering all of what you trying to hide. Amen? I feel like a friend going to tell me, girl, go into the bathroom because there's something white and I don't think it's a mole on your face. Amen? That's what a friend is going to do. A friend is going to say, I know you meant well, but you said this. It was the wrong thing. I just want to help you so the next time you won't make that mistake. Am I right? That's what we have to have in a friend because we can trust that whatever is going on, they're going to be honest with us. They're going to give us the truth. Well, that is what God has given us when he allows us to go through things, but he pulls us out. Amen? What we can't go through, we will go over because we belong to God. And God has a work for us to do. And if he doesn't give us what we need to do it, then it's not on us. We don't have the kind of power that we need. We can only get that from Jesus. Amen? He said that he came. He's the one. He died on that cross. He suffered everything that we would be able to use today so that we can operate in a way that nobody can take away the joy that God has given us. Nobody can take away the love and the life that God has given us. Nobody but Jesus can give us a peace and a comfort even when a loved one goes on to be with the Lord. Why? Because there's a peace that surpasses all understanding. And you don't know that if you're not a child of God. It's an inheritance thing. Am I right? You must be a part of the family. You must have accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So that why? So that you can receive the kingdom recipe of life. Glory be to God. So that we can receive everything that God has for us. But we have to get to a place where we're not constantly giving the devil all of God's glory. That we have to get to a place that we recognize every time something happens, that's not that God is mad with you. First of all, God won't get mad with you. Amen. He was done away with that in the Old Testament. He said he'll never, and I'm paraphrasing, he said that I won't do this again. Because he realized that, wait a minute, these jokers just need help. So he gave us Jesus. We needed some help. Amen. Amen. Because we wasn't getting it right. Now, how good of a God is it that he would allow his son to not just go through what he did on that cross, but then to still just stand by us, to hang out with us, no matter where we are, he's still right there. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Amen. Woo, Jesus, glory be to God. I don't don't know about you, but what I do know, that every time I think about the goodness of Jesus, I feel a right now praise, just like Joseph, that when they pulled him out of that pit, when they pulled him out of that jail, even when they pulled him out of the hands of that wife that was trying to get him, every time he had a reason to shout, glory be to God, because the enemy's desire is that you get caught up in something that you can't get out of, but that's not God's way. Glory be to God. Why? Because the Holy Ghost is with us every inch of the way. God is using the Spirit of the Lord to encourage us. God is using Jesus to be right there, even when we can't talk on our own behalf. Jesus is our advocate to the Father. Woo! Hallelujah! Woo! We don't even have to worry about it. We just got to know our brother is right there. Glory be to God. That's good news. Amen. So let me just try to get down here to a few points. Amen. It's hot. I said to my son, we ain't going to stay out there all day today because it's hot. And the problem that I had with the heat, you know, God can do whatever he wants to do. But I just wish that after I do all this sweating, that some pounds could go somewhere. Woo, Jesus, if I could go and just stand on the scale and it wouldn't be the same number, Miss Elam, that I left out with, I feel pretty good. But that's all right. Whatever you want to do, God, you know it's all on you. But I thank God because today we get to look at what's happening in the perspective of Joseph's story. Joseph went through a lot. But Joseph had to be pruned, and we have to be pruned. We have to go through some stuff, but God always gives us a nugget or a week or what I call an appetizer to get us to the next place. Amen? We're not forgotten. We are not forgotten. Not only are we not forgotten, but God knows our name. Glory be to God. And no matter what goes on, he will call out Sharon. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He will say, Mary, I need you to take a step back. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, because he loves us. And he wouldn't have sent Jesus to the cross if he wasn't going to do everything he needed to do to make sure that we were caught up as fishers of men. Amen. Glory be to God. So we thank God. Point number one, what happens when we don't get pruned? Amen. What happens when scissors don't begin to take off bits and pieces of what doesn't belong? Amen. What happens to us? We begin to suffer some things. Give me a second here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When we're not pruned, when we don't go through what we need to go through, just like children matriculating through school, there's some things that can happen. One of those things that can happen can be a delay. Amen. But before I get too far, keep in mind that a delay is not a denial. Glory be to God. But because God loves us so much, he will allow us to experience being in the delay. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because the delay is going to help us to get what we need to get. You know, it's like when those plays, they have to just kind of circle before they can get ready to land or to take off. That's what God does with us. And he let us be grounded right there. Be in that delay until we get what we need to go the next walk of the way. Those are good things. That's good news, because once again, we're seeing that God has not given up on us. I don't care what the enemy tries to tell you. When the enemy starts to talk to you about your future and what's going on with your past, you just remind him of where he's going to end up in his destiny. Glory be to God, because God has us in the palm of his hand. Glory be to God, because he loves us. And right there in that delay, glory be to God, right there in that place of where we look like, you know, I've been to a place and I was like, okay, God, do you hear me? I don't hear you, God. Have you moved your hands from me? And it was right at a time when I was right there in the Lord's hands, and I could not understand. God, I'm not hearing you, Father. Oh, God, help me. What do I need to do, Lord God, to stop feeling like I don't feel your presence anymore? And as time went on, I did come out of that thing. But in maturity, when I look back, what God was doing is saying, you've been doing a good job, but I need you to do a better job. Amen. I need you to do more reading. I need you to do more evangelizing. I need you to stop being afraid to talk to people. I need you to go ahead, and even though you don't feel like it, I need you to step out there. I know it's hot out there. I know you got polymorph and sun erosion, and it's going to make you sick. But baby, if you do what I tell you to do, I promise you I'm going to take care of your skin. You're going to be all right. Yes, you only have one airway passage, but I promise you, I called you out to be an evangelist. I will give you all the air that you need to have to do what I've called you to do. I know that your arm and your hand are in pain, but baby, if you trust me, I am the God that heals. Hallelujah, Lord God. And here I am today, in spite of it all, because of being in the delay, I learned patience. Amen. That's another thing that we get out of the delay. That's the one, another thing we get when we begin to be pruned. We get patience. Hallelujah. I think I was allergic to patience. Sometimes I think I'm still allergic to patience. Amen. But we learn patience in the delay, because in that place of delay, we get to experience that we are to wait on the Lord. Amen. And not wait on the Lord as if we are serving him. Amen. What can I help you with? No, that's not what God is talking about. He's saying, keep reading my word. Trust me and know that I am God, that everything I said is so. Amen. It's been settled in the heavens already. I got you. Glory be to God. You are well taken care of. Just keep trusting me. Just keep knowing me. Everybody is frantic round about now, because all that money, Miss Mary, that's been coming, it looked like it might stop, Miss Elam, and folks don't know quite what to do. Amen. But I tell you, who the Son of Man is set free is free indeed, and the bank of heaven that we have is ours. It will never run dry. Glory be to God. Daddy God, here's what your daughter needs. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I bet you if you trust Jesus, you'll start finding money. Oh, wait a minute. Let me reverse that. Money will start finding you. Woo, Jesus. Glory be to God. Because that's the God we serve. He knows what we're going through. This didn't catch him off by chance. He knew it from the beginning to the end. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So we have to trust God. We have to know that the delay is not a denial. We have to know that it's working patience. Amen. Working it out for our good. The next thing here, if we don't allow ourselves to be pruned, we will have to deal with unnecessary hardships, unnecessary consequences. I think that was a road that I lived on for a long time. Yes, ma'am. That was a road. I think the road was about to be named Sharon Yvette Harley, because she stayed here. It was like God had said, baby girl, you know, you can do this the easy way or the hard way. And I was one of those crazy kids that just said, oh, me, Jesus, I just want to do it the hard way. But God knew, even in my ignorance, you know, that girl does not know what she's doing. She needs a little bit more Jesus' help. So, son, go and just douse the oil on her. Help her sister out, because she's staying in a place too long, and I need her to do a work. Amen. I need her to come out of the delay. I need her to stop having to deal with these consequences that are trying to take her out, because I love her. I have called her to a certain place in this world that she would not just live, but she would live abundantly, that she would carry the word of God, not just in Fayetteville, in the DMV, but she would preach the gospel throughout the universe, that she would go into Samaria and all Judea. So help her get out of that place where she's stuck. My Lord, because I'm going to tell you, my children know, I stayed in that hard way for so long that by the time they came from, I told them, I said, you got a choice. But what you don't have a choice about, you will serve God. You will get there either the... That's right. You're going to get there the easy way or the hard way. And then I tell you next, you don't want to go to... Amen. Take it from one that's been there. Glory be to God. Because I'm here to help you. I'm not trying to hurt you. But why go through something that I can help you out with? Why go through something that ain't going to do you no good. It's going to further delay you with the call that God has for your life. So get on up and see yourself the way God sees you and stop believing that you got to keep going through these experiences yourself. The hand of God is on your life, and whatever you need, God's got it. Hallelujah. Whatever we need, God's got it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. My last point here. The ability to fully operate in our call or our gifting. What happens in the life of a pair of scissors? What happens when we don't get pruned? What happens when we don't accept the pruning and understand God's word that those whom he loves, he chastens. Hallelujah. That those that he has called, he shall protect. He will not just give you life. The word is clear that he will make an abundant life. The word of God says, and we talked about this morning, that his word declares that he is not a God that shall lie. Amen. So whatever he has said in the word of God, it is settled in the heavens, family. And we don't have to worry about it no more because it's already settled. God didn't send Jesus to that cross just because. He did it to take care of a debt. Not one that's going to knock at your door in a few years. If he say your debt is settled, it's settled. Hallelujah. But do we know that the debt's been settled? Have we received that the debt's been settled? Because if we don't, that's why we walk around, oh, woe is me. I don't know what I'm going to do. I just, over and over again, I'm in the same old situation. Well, it's time to ask the question, why? Wait on the Lord. Jesus, help me, brother. I need to know why I keep going around in the desert. Like, was it the Hebrew children? Come out of there. It's time to go. Amen. Cross on over the Red Sea. Trust that God's got something better for you. You and I don't have to stay down because they kicked us down. The devil is a lie. Remember our brother David? He came out and he said to Goliath, you big old ugly. I don't know what all he said to Goliath right now. But I know he said, regardless to what you look like, my God is bigger than your rock, your sword, whatever it is. I will just knock you down. Amen. I will take you out. Didn't he say it? And what did that shepherd boy do? He got himself 5 smooth stones. Now, I got to do some research. Why did they have to be smooth? Uh-huh, amen. Uh-huh. Some of y'all might be smarter than me and might know the answer. Amen. But he had to get 5 smooth stones. Now, I heard Jasmine Scurlock said that was one for his brother, the other brother of Goliath, and his mama and his daddy. Take all of them jokers out. Amen. And so whatever it was, we know that with one, he went down with a slingshot. Glory be to God. Don't you know that the same God that David depended on is the same one we have today? He has not changed. He's the same thing. And today, he's doing miracles right now. People are asking, is God still performing miracles? I'm one. And it would take me a lifetime to tell you all of what he's done in my life. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. So we have to know and understand that we're going to work fully in our gifting. We have to come away and allow God to separate us from those things, those people that he's been telling us to leave, get away from. Can't you see they holding you back? Can't you see they don't mean you no good? I got you to go here and you trying to stay there. And they're trying to bring them with you. My God, I got you taken care of. Let it go. Move on. See what the end is going to be. Stop bringing straddlers with you. Amen. If they wanted to go, they could have been gone. Don't let them hold you back. Don't continue going through the consequences that are going to be hard for you. It's time to come out. Come out. Allow God's good work to help to make us right, to prune away everything that doesn't belong, even the things that we want to hold on to. Right. Let it go. Trust God that he has something that's so much better. Thank you, Jesus. I think about had I not trusted God when he was opening up the door for me to come back here, all of the beauty of experiencing you all, I would have never had. I would have had stories of my mother and when I was a little girl going down these streets and being bit over in the cul-de-sac at my best friend's house. But the memories, glory be to God, that God has given me now, because in spite of how I felt coming back and forth up and down that road, the beauty of life and relationships that he's given me now, oh my, I would not give back for nothing in this world. Oh, I wouldn't take nothing for it. God is good, but we have to be faithful to the journey. Oh, I thank you, God. Oh, God, I thank you. Thank you, Jesus. So, because God is good. So here we are. Our scripture text to hold on to for this week. Amen.
Amen.
I'm thirsty, y'all. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew chapter 6, verse 3. And this is the scripture to ponder over as the days go by. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It says, but when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing.
All right.
So that your giving may be in secret. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, mm-hmm, will reward you. Hallelujah. God is going to take care of us. Stop running your mouth and falling the plane, because that's what happened to Joseph. He done brothers got scared. Y'all thought I lost my point, didn't you? I was able to go back around the corner. Eek! I did it, Ezekiel. Wrap that thing up. Let's get back to Joseph. Joseph opened up his mouth. He wasn't supposed to. But here's what we do know. That whatever happens, God did it. And he did it for a reason. And I would dare say, because I know he loved me, I'm like John, he loves me. He did it so that I would know and understand that I needed you to see what happens here. That just because you end up in the pit every now and then, baby girl, I got you. Even when you get to the palace and you think you good and stuff is still happening, I still got you. I don't take you to a place and remove my hands. I still got you. My grace is sufficient no matter where you go, how you get there. I got you. Thank you, God, because God is good. But we have to keep in mind that we cannot be telling everybody and everything that God gives us. Some things you got to keep to the breast. Amen. Shut up. Be quiet. Everything that comes to your mind don't need to come out of your mouth. Hallelujah. You know, I tell folks sometimes I look at people, I don't sit in judgment of nobody. Okay, God, but forgive me for a minute. So anyway, you know, people see stuff in the stores. This is Sharon talking. I'm just going to be real for just a minute.
Go ahead, Sharon.
So, you know when we could go to stores? And we, all the mannequins were thin, right? Didn't look like none of us. Well, maybe Miss Mary. All the mannequins were all like, you know, they fit. They got on the clothes. They looking sharp. I'm 400 pounds. That ain't going to fit me. Just because they selling it don't mean you need to buy. Whoa. Hallelujah.
On,
my
man.
God. We don't need to be just going with things because it's there. Check with Jesus. What did God say? What would Jesus do? Uh-huh. Let's make it real. What would, look at that bracelet. What would Jesus do?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus would not be doing some of the things that you and I have done when we know better.
All right.
We know better. But we push the envelope. We act like little children. Oh, he gonna forgive us. Let me tell you something. I don't know what God is gonna do in your life. I'm only responsible for my life. Amen. But I do know that there's such a time as being too late. And if we don't begin to watch and know what's happening here, use wisdom with what God is doing, we're going to fall short. And we're going to end up in a place that we did not want to have to deal with. All because we would not listen. We would not believe God's word that it is his will that all would be saved. But the reality of it is, some is going to be scrolled, selected, and deleted. Amen? So we have to trust God. We have to believe him. We need to know when to keep things to the belly. Don't say everything you hear. Amen. Don't buy everything they sell. Amen. Keep buying wooden nickels. I don't even know nothing about wooden nickels. I just heard stories. But we don't need to be following in that step.
Amen.
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 I'm done, y'all. And I'm tired.
I know.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. To God be the glory. Because we truly thank him for his word. And we can learn a whole lot when we accept being pruned. When we understand that it's not God's will to hurt us. But God is simply trying to help us. Give me some, please. God is simply trying to help us to get where we need to be. I need to sit down here.
Amen.
to his honor. Hallelujah. in Jesus. I knew God would send me to choir. Lord. Hallelujah. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Now for the most important part here today, for those of you that don't know Jesus and the partner you said, amen. I can't imagine on a Sunday afternoon that you, if you're watching me, that you don't know him, but we can't take it for granted. Right. So if you're not sure or you don't know him, it's as easy as accepting him as Lord and Savior, believing it in your heart. Romans 10:9 said, if you believe in your heart, you confess with your mouth, hallelujah, that Jesus is Lord, hallelujah, you are saved. And John 10, I believe it is, says that can't nobody pluck you out of his hand. Now, you can denounce him, but can't nobody take you. So we thank God that now is the time. Time is running out. If you haven't been watching what's going on, things are not getting better. I heard from my children earlier that today we know John Lewis passed away, and they put up Elijah Cummings' picture, some of the Republicans, and we know they were being funny to do that. Their attempt was to act like all black folks look alike. But I'm telling you, God's got a special place in how he's going to deal with the good, the bad, and the ugly. Amen? You don't want to find yourself nowhere near the indifferent or the ugly. You want to be on the side of good. Good God. Amen? Because otherwise, things are going to come to an abrupt end. And if you're not sure about your salvation, there is such a time as too late. Hallelujah. So we ask, Lord God, that you would just continue to be with the families, Lord God. Continue to build them up, Lord God. Continue to give them insight into your word, Father, in the name of Jesus. Help them to know, Lord God, that no matter what delays they get in, Lord God, that is not a denial. That no matter how many times, Lord God, they find themselves swimming but feeling not like they're not moving, Lord God, they're just going through a little pruning, Lord God. But after a while, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, they will be released from that place, Lord God. And then the troubles are not older, Lord God, over, because you got more for us, God. But we are getting stronger through every adversity, Father. And we thank you that you're on our side, Father. Oh, God, we thank you for this message. We ask, Lord God, that you continue to be with us. Strengthen us in your word, Lord God, in Jesus' precious and righteous name. Now, for those that have been kind enough to donate to us and give an offering, you can go to Run and Shout Ministries, the number 1.org. There is everything you need. But most importantly, check out what we're doing as RandSEIM. Amen. And that will give you more insight as to who we are as a people. To God be the glory. Amen, son. Amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Amen. Hallelujah.